sing of the damage. Now that the calm's returned, I know I can't manage. You're standing in my doorway, though he's asleep in my bed. The steady murmur always in my head. You're the funniest thing that I've done. The hurricane I'll never outrun.
I'm Janie.
I'm Claire.
I'm Robin.
And I'm Sarah.
And we're walking the Relay for Life for a documentary project.
We must save more lives, and we must do so faster. To not take action, to not fight back year-round, is to let cancer win.
It's just talk. Smiles politely back at you. You stare politely right on through. Some sort of window to your right. She goes left and you stay right. Past his defense without granting innocence. Lay down a list of what is wrong, things you told him all along. Pray to God he hears you, and pray to God he hears you.
So in July of 2009, I was diagnosed with acute biphenotypic leukemia, and basically that's like the most rarest type of leukemia you can get. And I had to miss my first, like the first semester of my junior year, because I was busy doing treatments and recovery and everything. And after like three rounds of radiation and three rounds of chemo, I had my bone marrow transplant on October 14th of 2009, which was, I think, 5 days after my birthday, with my 16th birthday. And to me, that was the greatest gift ever, because my bone marrow transplant was from my sister, and she was a 10 for 10 perfect match. And I was just so thankful for that, because most kids, they get cars, but I got bone marrow transplant. So that saved my life. After going through what I had to go through with fighting cancer, my view on life is very different. I feel like people take things for granted and they don't appreciate everything that they have. And like, people always say, oh yeah, my life sucks. I'm like, okay, well, if you had cancer, yeah, then your life would really suck. But I mean, if your mom grounded you, oh man, that really sucks. Like, ooh. But I mean, just like, it's changed me a lot. It's made me a lot mature. It's made me realize that, like, you know, you can't mess around. You need to, like, you can have fun, but you need to, like, you need to know what's important and that life is short.
must fight back to honor the memories of all the people cancer has taken away from us. We must fight back to protect our children, brothers, sisters, parents, aunts, uncles, grandparents, and friends from this disease.
Walking for Sue. We're sponsoring Lance. He's in our FFA. Well, yeah, that's what we're doing. We're here for FFA.
I'm walking for my grandmother who died from breast cancer.
I'm walking for my grandma who died of lung cancer and my aunt who has breast cancer and Jennifer and everyone.
My name's Sherry Bates and I'm an oncology nurse and I am here supporting I've worked with and who are still here and fighting and who are surviving and those who have passed on.
I walk for my grandpa.
I walk for my mother who survived cancer. I walk for Elise Gold and Jennifer Chung.
I walk for my dad.
My name is Haley Gold and I have been team captain for Team Gold for 2 years now for Relay for Life. And I relay in order to honor my dad, who's a cancer survivor, and in memory of my mom, who died of cancer 4 years ago.
Money to defeat cancer.
What?
Running and running. Laps! Running and running. Laps! Saving money to defeat cancer.
I learned at Relay for Life that cancer is something that almost everyone has to deal with. I learned that it's not just me who had someone who was affected by cancer. Like, a lot of people have friends and family and coworkers and stuff that have been affected by cancer, and that since we all know someone who's been through it, we can all work together to make it less of a problem in our community.
At Relay for Life, I learned that cancer is stoppable, and with routine screenings, we can significantly decrease the numbers of people affected by cancer.
When I was there, I really saw like a big community of souls like reaching out and trying to help all these people that are affected by cancer, and I learned that it's really, even though it's a really deadly disease, it's not really something to be afraid of because there's so many people always trying to help you all the time and they're always going to be there for you. And it's just something that you could do out of.
At Relay for Life, I learned that even though cancer isn't tangible and you can't look at it and feel it, it still affects a lot of people. And that you can help stop it by spreading the word about cancer, by helping people learn how to prevent it, by going to their doctor and getting a checkup every year. And that cancer never sleeps, and we need to always keep spreading the information and try to stop the spread of cancer.
In honor, in memory, and in support of all those who have faced this disease, we will fight back. Talking back, yeah, that's all.